There's a teaching I like from the teacher Clarissa Pinkola Estes. I've listened to many of her wonderful audio programs on Sounds True. I don't remember which one this teaching is from, but at a certain point she says, these three C's. Do not complain. Do not criticize. Do not condemn. And I think that's great advice. You've got to notice, if I start complaining, I start criticizing, or I get into condemnation, how do I feel? Not how I would like to feel. Yoga is very practical. It recognizes that everything we do is training. So if we make a habit of complaining, criticizing, condemning, we're basically training ourselves in the ways of feeling tense, miserable, uneasy. So much better to make way for the positive day and help each other on the way with a more positive outlook. And so in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna, the teacher, tells his student Arjuna, when Arjuna is really feeling overwhelmed, he's on the floor not knowing what to do, Krishna tells him, Arjuna, this is your lucky day. This is what you've been waiting for. This is what you've been asking for. Because this challenging situation is the opportunity to discover more of your depth, to uncover more of your true potential, to actually reconcile and harmonize all the different parts of yourself into greater unity. And so in yoga, there's not really such a thing as an obstacle or a problem. As one of my friends says, obstacles are not on the path. Obstacles are the path. Without obstacles, the path would not allow us to unwrap those gifts that might not be presented in the packaging we perhaps have chosen, but which are the gifts we need, the opportunities we've been waiting for, to really uncover more of our innate capacities. More of those capacities that have perhaps been veiled or hidden, concealed by these limiting tendencies and limiting patterns that we might have got into unconsciously. And so a positive attitude of seeing everything as an opportunity is a wonderful help on the yoga path. And this positivity is also conveyed very beautifully in Patañjali's Yoga Sūtra, another foundational text of teaching in the yoga tradition. And one thing that I find very, very beautiful in this text is that there are no negative instructions. Patañjali does not deal in don't. So I appreciate this 3C teaching that I heard from Clarissa Pinkola Estes. I think it's a great thing for me to work with. If I catch myself going into criticism, condemnation, or complaining, to try to catch myself and stop and remember, this isn't probably going to lead me where I would like to go. But a beautiful thing in yoga is that it doesn't do not. Because the yogic masters recognize the human brain doesn't do so well with negative instruction. Think of anything you like, but don't think of a red Ferrari. It's a rare human being who manages not to think of a red Ferrari when they hear such an instruction. And so it's a really striking and beautiful thing in the yoga tradition that instead of prohibitive instructions, we get proactive, encouraging instructions. And so when Patañjali in the Yoga Sutra lays out the foundation ways of how we can use our energy in life, it's all done in a positive way. And we get these yama principles, five of them. And these five yamas, sometimes people translate them as restrictions or restraints. And this is not inaccurate, because sometimes yama will mean being restrained, restricting ourselves. But yama also has the sense of channeling, harnessing. And so yamas, as well as being things that they might sometimes push us towards not doing something, really they're active principles that we practice all the time. And after Patañjali introduced them in the Yoga Sutra, he says, these are the great vow to be working at all times and all places, they're positive things. And so the idea of the yamas is all to support this principle of ahimsa. Now ahimsa often gets translated as non-harm. And again, this is not inaccurate. Non-harming is a very important part of ahimsa. But ahimsa is not something we don't. It's an active principle that we do, we practice it, we attend to it all the time. So I think it's much more helpful to think of ahimsa as cultivating harmony, cultivating a positive vibration, cultivating that type of attitude that transforms things that could, to a certain way of seeing, seem like a problem, into an opportunity for learning and growth. And this is the idea of yoga. What is life for? Our education, our enjoyment, and ultimately, our emancipation. We can learn, we can have fun as we learn, and we can learn how to live free. Free from compulsion, free from the bonds of our conditioned worlds, and actually make way